he gets a little carried away there.
My bad. Got a little carried away there. Thanks, Rhea.
So now that we have everybody's attention in the room, we would like to say...
Welcome to the 2020 SAAO Follies.
My name is Matt, and I am the Vice President for SAAO. And classically, the Follies has been sponsored by SAAO, and last year, it kind of took a little bit of a hiatus. But 2020 is a year of the revival, so here we are, and about to bring you an amazing show.
And my name is Sim. I'm the national representative of SAAO. Some of you might recognize me as the guy who chased you around campus to buy tickets to come here. We have an amazing show for you here tonight. There's a great lineup of performers that are dying to put on a show for you, and definitely not doing it for the touch hours. So to get this show started, please help us welcome the most good-looking guys to take the stage since One Direction. And sorry, ladies, it's not Dr. Newman. Please put your hands together for the host of the evening,
Aaron Big Skinny,
and Nathaniel the Hype Man Jordan.
WVSOM! How are we tonight? Woo! We are so excited and honored to be here with you tonight for the resurrection of the Follies.
That's right, Aaron. Tonight we are going to showcase the many hidden talents of several members of our WVSOM family.
That's right. So our performers tonight are not just medical students, professors, physicians, but they are also extremely gifted musicians, singers, dancers, martial artists,
it's a word.
You name it. That's a new thing.
That's right. Tonight's first performers coming to the stage is Amanda Malnikoff, I had to practice that, and Zach Uzzel performing Stone by Whiskey Meyer on guitar and piano.
Did you know that Amanda was an all-star saxophonist? And get it, Zach can drive a manual transmission, eat a whole ribeye in one sitting, and he owns two cowboy hats.
I think we were only supposed to say the part about the two cowboy hats.
Sorry.
Well, anyways, go ahead and put your hands together and welcome up Zach and Amanda. Woo!
Thank you.
Isn't that just beautiful?
It's okay, man. I know.
They
I know.
Really love each other, too.
I know.
It's precious. Anyway, gosh. Our next performer is a Follies legend. Tonight, drumroll please, will be his 10th performance at WVSOM's Follies.
Just wow. Dr. Larry Davis is a WVSOM professor emeritus of biochemistry who retired in 2007, but he facilitates clinical skills labs for the past 12 years.
Performing poi spinning to the music of Mozart and Jerry Lee Lewis, Great Balls of Fire, put your hands together for Dr. Davis.
Okay, that was fun. That little piece right there, that's a part of Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart's Sonata number 11 for piano. That's an orchestral version of the thing. And that was one of his big hits in the 18th century. Next. Featured on the screens will be a big hit of Jerry Lee Lewis in the 1950s. Go!
You shake my nerves and you rattle my brain.
Thank you. Thanks for coming tonight.
Shoo, is it hot in here or is it those great balls of fire? Am I right?
Nathaniel, it's just me.
Oh, please, honey. I'm a hot mess 24/7.
You got that right. Yeah.
True. So, Aaron?
Nathaniel, what do you get when you cross NASA, NASCAR, and soccer?
Do you guys know? I couldn't possibly imagine. Could you please enlighten all of us?
Well, you know, honestly, I don't really know either. But our next performer was in the top 0.14% of Rocket League players. That's a video game, by the way. That sounds like something that's probably a mix of NASA, soccer, and NASCAR, right?
Yeah, sure, whatever you say.
Okay, cool. Well, Brandon Wan will be playing a medley of Bohemian Rhapsody and All of Me on piano. So let's give it up for Brandon.
Thank you.
Nathaniel, doesn't listening to piano just make you feel so darn fancy? I feel like I should be sipping on some champagne.
Allow me, good sir.
Oh! Oh my gosh! Nathaniel!
I'm sorry. I didn't know. It was really sparkly, so I thought it would be nice.
Well, hopefully our next act is much more enjoyable than that. I almost had a heart attack.
Me too.
Yeah, well, all right, next up we have Andrew Kohlbank performing Being Alive from Stefan Sondheim's musical Company.
Aside from medicine, Andrew was a cantor in the Pittsburgh Oratory Choir and was in over 20 different theatrical productions. After graduating, Andrew plans on attending seminary to become a deacon in the Catholic Church.
Wow. Did you also know that Andrew has a different outfit for every day of the week?
Stop it.
Month?
Are you kidding me?
And year?
Shut up.
So he hasn't never worn an outfit twice.
I don't believe it.
So, well, let's see what he's wearing today. Please welcome Andrew to the stage.
Someone to hold you too close. Someone to hurt you too deep. Someone to sit in your chair and ruin your sleep. Someone you have to let in. Someone whose feelings you spare. Someone who, like it or not, would want you to share a little, a lot of being alive. Someone to need you too much. Someone to know you too well. Someone to pull you up short, to put you through hell, and give you support for being alive. Make me alive. Make me confused. Mock me with somebody make me come through. I'll always be there, as frightened as you, to help us survive. Being alive. Being alive. Being alive.
Thank you. That was great.
Wonderful job, yes. Andrew.
All right. Give a quick Spotify search and you'll find our next performer, Eric Nicolau. His first love was music.
All right.
What really drives him is how music connects people to tell their stories. One of his favorite movies is The One That Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest.
Hey, Nathaniel, I think I want to be on Spotify. Hold on.
Oh, no. Aaron.
Ah!
enough. Please. Just leave it to the professional. Oh. He's going to be really good.
Okay, fine. Can't fault a man for trying. Come on.
Anyways, I think our next performer is going to really give Justin Bieber a run for his money.
Let's give it up for Eric Nicolaou. Woo!
Get it, razão pra mim não é porque ela disse que é belo coração. Quero ver você mandar. Na razão pra mim não é porque ela disse que é belo coração. Toda hora é hora de decisão. Falo gorda. No fundo julgo o fato consumado. Vão me embolar. Não quero mais me aprofundar nessa história. Não sei os meus anseios, perco eu vivo de miúdia. Eu quero é viver em paz. Por favor, me beija a boca. Que louca, que louca. Eu quero é viver em paz. Por favor, me beija a boca. Que louca, que louca. Bought myself a hard pack of cigarettes in the early morning rain. Lately my hands, they don't feel like mine. My eyes been stung with dust and blind. Held you in my arms one time. I lost you just the same. Jolene, I ain't about to go straight. It's too late. I found myself face down in the ditch, bruise in my hair, blood on my lips. Picture you holding a picture of me in the pocket of my blue jeans. Still don't know what love means. Still don't know what love means. Jolene, la 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 la. Been so long since I've seen your face. I felt a part of this human race. Been living out of this here suitcase for way too long. A man needs something he can hold on to. A 9-pound hammer or a woman like you. Either one of them things will do. Jolene, I ain't about to go straight. It's too late. I found myself face down in the ditch, losing my hair, blood on my lips. Picture of you holding a picture of me in the pocket of my blue jeans. Still don't know what love means. Still don't know what love means. Jolene, da 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 da.
Thank you.
God, please bring the rain. Yeah, bring it soon. Let it flood right through the houses into Judy's room. With the father on amphetamines, the mother hides the pearls. Reach out into the darkness and find my little girl. She's angry like a salesman who just couldn't make a sale. Threw a wedding ring in the sewer and damned them all to hell. Please lead her to the mountain that you fashioned out of sand. With the roaches climb the walls, with a hotel where he calls. Most people never find a love. Most people never find a love. Sometimes you just can't be a man. Sometimes you just can't be a man. When you're living in the darkness, the shadowlands, the shadowlands, the shadowlands.
That was great, Eric.
It's just amazing. Wow.
I know. The next American Idol right there.
For real.
That was awesome. I'll buy your CD. Anyways, you might recognize this next act from your lunch breaks on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Fridays. Besides his day job of crushing you world questions, he also does stand-up comedy on the side.
Nathaniel, are you feeling clogged and bogged down with board studying? I've got just the thing for you.
Stop. That's enough.
Okay, I was trying to help, man. Come on.
Gosh. Well, thank you for that. I feel so much better.
Good, good, good.
Please welcome to the stage, Abdul Nazif.
How you guys doing tonight? So, are you guys ready? First aid. So, first aid 2019. Please open up to page 580.
This isn't lecture. This isn't board study time.
It's supposed to be a comedy act.
You didn't tell me about this.
You told us you were doing comedy.
We're tired of bored.
What am I supposed to talk about, dude?
It's a Saturday.
We want to laugh.
What am I supposed to talk about?
Whatever you feel comfortable. You need to be funny.
Arabs, is that okay?
Yeah. I mean, if you want to, just get out there.
Hey guys. All right. So, my name is Abdul Nazif, and I'm Arab. Yeah. So if you ever go to the Middle East, and you meet any kind of guy, and you'd have to guess to what their name is, you either guess Ahmed, Muhammad, or Abdul. You'll probably win. You'll probably get it right. So if it was a multiple choice question, you're clicking one of those, okay? All right. So, you know, I was raised up in Syria and lived in Saudi Arabia for a good bit of my life. Saudi Arabia, I saw a lot of crazy things, but my biggest memory is crazy driving Arabs. They drive really, really fast. If you ever go on the highways, you look to the right, you don't see those cars. So, I couldn't wait until I get older and get a car. So I came to America and I got my license. So my parents got me a 1995 Dodge Caravan. Let me tell you, that thing was barely working. All right, it works. I couldn't wait until I get on the highway and until I became a good driver, I'm like, okay, I have to wait until I become good enough to be able to get on the highway. So I finally got on the highway, and the car, you know, the meter says 120. I'm a daring Arab, and I wanted to see if I could push 120. So I'm like, all right, let's be reasonable. Let's first try 100. If it works, it works. If it doesn't, maybe that was my last day. So I went on the highway, tried 100. Got there, got to 100, and all you hear is, and the steering wheel was shaking pretty bad. I was trying to really control it. I didn't know what was gonna happen next. Well, let me tell you what happened next. All I hear is wee 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 wee. Damn it! The cops are behind me. All right, I stop on the side, and remember, this is a 1995 car. The guy goes like, "Sir, you were speeding pretty fast." I'm like, "Yes, sir, I had it on cruise, sir." Remember, this is a 1995 car. In 1995, they didn't know what cruise control was. So the car didn't really have any cruise control. So he looked at me, and I lived in Pennsylvania. I didn't live in Virginia. So the guy let me off. I never got a ticket. Pushing 100 on a 60 or 70, I couldn't really remember. But that was a lesson. My parents were pretty mad at me. But I don't know. Maybe it's genetic. I don't know what's going on. What happens down there, I can just see the road. But my leg always, you know, it licks the pedal. So, you know, I started med school, and I had to drive from Pennsylvania to West Virginia. And I have to go through Virginia. Now, Virginia, you can't do this arguing thing, all right? You stop. The first thing they tell you, they don't say hi, hello. They're like, license and registration, please. So my thing was, whenever a cop stopped me, I said, I had on cruise control, sir. So that didn't really work in Virginia, except one time, actually, where it worked. And I told the guy, it was 11:30, 12 o'clock at night, and I told the police officer that there's a devil in this area, and that's why my car is somehow speeding all by itself. He actually let me off because he said I was the first guy that ever made him laugh. So, true story, I'm not kidding. So, my parents always got really, really mad at me for speeding. Mom would always call me right when I get to West Virginia, and she says, hi. I'm like, hi, Mom, I love you. She's like, how much was it this time? And then I would tell her, you know, 200 plus. And then she'd be like, I'm like, I love you, Mom. She hung up. Now, Dad, on the other hand, he doesn't call. He doesn't answer my phone calls. He waits until I get home the next time. I walk home, like, Dad, I love you. How are you? That's how we do in the Arab countries. We kiss our parents on each side, on each cheek. And he's like, look, let me tell you something. You hear me? I'm like, I hear you. Arabs love to use their hand, guys. They love to use their hands. They use their hands with everything they do. He's like, look, let me tell you something. You drive very fast. Very, very fast. You drive fast like this. You see the grave? They close it up and they buckle it up right on you. Dead. Drive slow. Make a slow. He always did this. He's like, make it slow. Make it slow. Okay? Make it slow. I'm like, okay, Dad, I will. So I've been really working on it. I mean, this has been really harder than med school, my driving experiences. So this last time, about six weeks ago, I had to go from home to here. And every time I passed by Virginia, it was a rule for me. I stopped all the music that I was playing. Okay. Actually put on cruise control and started playing Quran. Do you guys know what Quran is? So I'm Muslim, and it's basically just like the Bible. So I went pretty damn religious when I got to Virginia. Okay, never been more religious. So this time, I had to go from Pennsylvania to West Virginia. It was 8 o'clock at night, so by the time I got here, it was 2 in the morning. I had work the next morning. I'm like, I'll make it to Virginia just fine. I can, you know, speed my usual. 10 minutes in, right when I got on the highway, I got stopped. Son of a gun. What did I do this time? I really wasn't speeding. So usually what happens is when I get stopped by a cop, I always put my seatbelt on really quickly. How many of you guys do that? Oh, I guess it's only Arab. Oh, and this guy as well. Okay. All right, so I put my seatbelt on really quickly, and here's the most important part. So right before I left home that day, Mom made this delicious dish. I don't eat sweets often, but my God, this thing is lovely. It has a lot of whipped cream on it, okay, guys? A lot of whipped cream. So I decided to eat it on the road. I don't have a girlfriend or a wife, so the seat next to me is just food. So, you know, I had the lineup ready. That dish was first in the lineup. So I was eating it, and apparently I was swerving right and left, and nobody knew about it. At least I didn't. But the cop did. So he comes up, and so again, he stops me. And this seatbelt never works. I'm pulling it. Come on, it's coming. Finally pulled over, put it in, and then I'm like, uh-oh, I didn't cover the dish. It's coming. So I'm crumbling, trying to get this dish settled in so he won't look at it. So I close it up. It's see-through. He can see a spoon right through there. So he comes up. He's like, Abdul. He's like, how you doing, sir? I'm like, how you doing, sir? I had on cruise control. And he goes like, sir, are you drinking tonight? I'm like, no. No, sir. I'm a medical school student, and I'm Muslim. So he said, you know, you were swerving tonight. I'm like, swerving? Oh, yeah, I dropped my phone. I had to come up with something, right? So I'm like, I had dropped my phone, and I couldn't reach, and I couldn't see the road. Maybe I was swerving. Was I swerving? I was like, yeah, you were swerving. I'm like, okay, sorry, sir. He looks at me. He's like, what is that thing next to you? Were you eating that? I'm like, people eat while they're on the road? Are you serious? That's why we have so many accidents. I was like, okay, license and registration. Give me this thing. I'm like, sir, before you leave, I'm gonna get home by 2 o'clock in the morning, and I have work in the morning. Please don't be late. Beggars can't be choosers, right? So I'm like, please don't be late. Don't take too long. I was like, license and registration. Takes it. 20 minutes pass. 30 minutes pass. Where the heck is? Where's this guy? He's chilling in his car. 40 minutes pass. He's not showing up. I'm like, okay, time to turn up the music. Look at myself in the mirror. And guys, I had whipped cream all over my face. I looked down my shirt, and it's all whipped cream. He comes back, gives me my license and registration, and says, he didn't give me anything actually, and says, please eat that when you get home. All right, I have one more story for you guys tonight. You know, as I finished my first 2 years here, third and fourth year was pretty cool. But I had an experience my third year, and oh my God, this experience was just, I don't know how to explain it. But yeah, so I did a week of nights at a hospital for internal medicine. And we were sitting down waiting for patients, and my resident goes, hey, Abdul, we have a patient. He's going to be in negative pressure isolation room. He most likely has TB. I'm like, okay, cool. I look at him, and he looks at me. He's like, okay, let's go. I'm like, me? He's like, yeah, you. I'm like, okay, I'm ready. He's like, no, you. I'm like, together? He's like, no, you're going alone. I'm like, me alone? He's like, get out, let's go. I've never been in a negative pressure isolation room, so I have no clue what to do. I knew they wear this mask thing, but that's about it. So you wear an N95 mask. It was in the middle of the night. I go to this guy's room, dress up as well as I could, and I go into this guy's room. And I'm like, hey, sir, how you doing today? My name is Abdul. I'm a third year med school student. What's your name? He's like, I'm not going to tell you his name, but he said, my name is Joe. I'm making up a name. And he goes like, but don't call me Joe. They call me Hitchhiker of Motherly America. I'm like, okay, Mr. Joe, I have... No, don't call me Joe. Maybe you don't get it. My name is Hitchhiker of Motherly America. And he always gives that America, you know. So I'm like, okay. I ask him a bunch of questions. The guy had every symptom you could think of about TB. Now, what's important is where I rotated, the attending that was always with us always told us, if some guy comes in with rectal bleeding, you're doing a rectal exam no matter what. Okay? A rectal exam no matter what. A lot of residents missed it. He said, medical students or residents, if you guys miss it, we're going to have some serious issues. So I asked this guy if he has any rectal bleeding, and I was praying to God that he would say no, because I've never done one myself. But he said yes. Now, this guy has TB. I don't want to touch any of his mucosal surfaces, but I have to do a rectal exam because I didn't want to fail the rotation. So I'm like, sir. So before I go any further, I had no clue what a hitchhiker was, okay? But this guy apparently, I lived in America for about 14 years or so, but I didn't know what a hitchhiker was. And this guy has been to 4 prisons, done everything that you could ever possibly imagine. And I told him, I'm like, sir, I have to do a rectal exam on you. And he's like, what did you say? Now, I'm really terrified. I'm shaking with this guy because he threatened to kill everybody in the hospital multiple times. So I'm like, well, might as well. I might not make it out. So I started saying my prayers. So I told him, sir, look, I have to go get something quickly. I'll be back. We'll do a rectal exam. He's like, you better be quick. I'm like, all right. So I go out. Get gloves. I told the nurse, hey, you have to chaperone me. She comes in. I told her, you know, if I don't make it out, you know what happened. So I walk in. I put on 3 gloves. I didn't want to get any mucosal surfaces on my hand. Kept putting one on. The third one didn't fit, but I was really trying to fit it in there. Finally fit it in there. I couldn't feel my fingers. Walk in. I'm like, sir. The thing that I remembered about rectal or prostate exams is I had an attending that always told me, this is how you do it. Elbows on the table, bend down, and let's get to the end of this. So I walk into the room, and I had that memorized. Elbows on the table, bend down, and let's get to the end of this. So I'm like, sir, elbows on the table, bend down, and let's get to the end of this. He's like, what did you say? I'm like, sir, I just need to do this or my preceptor will kill me. I was like, okay, be quick. I couldn't remember how many fingers I had to do. It's 2 in the morning, guys. So I'm like, okay, 5 doesn't make sense. If this was a multiple choice, I think 4 wouldn't work either. 3? Okay, possibly, but let's leave that to later. I think 2 would be best. So I'm like, sir, here we go. Put my fingers in there.
Oh, you have 2 fingers in there?
Oh, sorry, sir. I look at the nurse and she's like. So I pull out my fingers really quickly. So I'm like, okay, it's got to be one. Which one is it? This one is too small. This one is all the way at the end. This is not going to work out. This one, I'm going to crumble a little bit. It's not going to work out. This one is way too inappropriate. It's got to be this one. So I put my fingers, oh! Okay, sir, we're done. I get out. And his pissed. I mean, I've never seen a guy so mad. So I'm walking out there, I'm backing out. Turn around, and hit my head right on the head, right on the door. See you, sir. So I walk out. I'm like, thank God I finished with this thing. And I said, uh-oh, I forgot the hemocult. So I never had the hemocult with me, and I never even looked to see if there was any blood on my fingers. So I'm like, okay, Abdul, you have 2 choices. You either walk in there and get killed, or you get killed by your preceptor tomorrow. All right, guys, that was the end of it for me today. Thank you.
So this next performance is a group of first and second year medical students who love Indian culture just as much as I love Indian food. They are excited to help promote diversity at WVSOM and showcase traditional dances that are from South Asia. Segments of this dance include classical Bharatanatyam, Bhangra, and Bollywood fusion. Try saying that 10 times fast.
I mean, you don't want me trying to say that 10 times fast. I can barely say the drugs that we have to say 10 times fast.
You got that right.
Thank you, pharmacologist. I'm talking to you, Dr. Bridges.
All right, let's give it up for Bollywood Blowout. Woo!
Do not. चल बेटा सेल्फी ले ले रे बरेली वाले झुमके पे जिया लल जाए कमर लचकाए तो लको गिर जाए बरेली वाले झुमके पे जिया लल जाए कमर लचकाए तो लको गिर जाए
आहे मारे रे ताना क्यों बनता है सयाना ना मैं तेरी गुजरिया ना तू मेरा दीवाना
Me and Billy drinking Guinness in the pub. Link Jimmy for the cross. AK-47 or the snuff. Me and Bangles on the rhythm, yeah, it's done. Skippy with it. Top 10, price up, I'm silly with it.
Wow, let's give it up one more time for Bollywood Blowout. That was amazing. Woo! All right. Unfortunately, that's going to conclude the first part of our show tonight.
That's right. It's time for intermission. So we're going to take a 10-minute break. Go stretch your legs. Go use the bathroom. Go take a drink. Whatever type of drink you want. But yeah, come back in 10 minutes so we can start the second half of our show.
Thank you all very much. We'll see you soon.
And welcome back for Act Two. Did y'all enjoy that break? All right. Well, we're looking for... Okay. Is Aaron out there? Is he pulling the number on me? Aaron! Aaron,
take my horse through the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
I got the horses in the back. Horse stock is attached. Head is matted black. Got the bushes black to match. Riding on a horse.
Our SGA president, everybody, Aaron. Okay, enough horsing around. We got a show to do.
All right.
Okay, up next we have the legendary Dr. Ward.
Woo! So, in addition to teaching medical anatomy, Dr. Ward loves teaching martial arts, which he refers to as involuntary yoga.
That's right. Tonight, he'll be demonstrating how to pop, lock, and drop it in martial arts, highlighting different ways that the body can be manipulated.
You know, he'll put the fall in follies.
Good joke. Thanks. Welcome to the stage, Dr. Ward and members of the Yatagarasu Dojo.
Woo!
All right. Thank you all very much for coming tonight. So, we've done multiple demos and follies in the past. It's always been a great time. Tonight, we're going to switch it up a little bit, and I'm going to be doing a demo with my students here, Bill Yarnell, Liza Bartlett. And I'm doing something that comes naturally to me. I'm turning it into an anatomy lecture. So essentially, we're going to be looking at the rotator cuff and how it's actually used to actually make these techniques work. So when you're talking about moving someone around, big muscles are hard to move. Smaller muscles are easier to move. Stop me if I'm going too quickly. So here, if I take Liza here and I'm trying to push her down, if I just push against the big muscles where she's stable, she's not going to let me. Yeah, I'm actually working, and it's not. Because I'm pushing against big muscles like the deltoid, like the pectoralis muscles. So what we're working is rotating the arm. And one thing I want you guys to notice is when I rotate the arm internally, I'm stretching the infraspinatus, teres minor muscles, and the balance tends to go when that happens. Likewise, if we balance the other way, we're going to take the arm into external rotation, Anybody want to tell me what muscle we're stretching? I can wait. Subscapularis is correct. No one who said that. So we're stretching the subscapularis, and notice as that rotation happens, it's going to wind up unbalancing the person as the muscle gets pulled completely tight and starts moving the body. So we're going to just really briefly go through some of those motions and how they're broken down. So here, Liza, I'll be attacking, actually number three attack. So what's happening, we block, move in, just pushing's no good, but we rotate and all of a sudden you can get the motion going right there. So she's going to get me unbalanced and then use that against me, hello, to do an elbow lock, tap me out. Number four. And other side. Same thing. Good. All right. Good. Thank you. Bill, come on in. So one thing I want you to notice is once the arm's done rotating, you can attack different parts of it. We've done that here in the past. But if you keep moving, pretty soon the shoulders run out of options. You can't really take any more slack out of it. And the rest of the body gets affected. So we'll do kaitenage. So here, number two attack. So he's going to be attacking. We get the arm rotated. And the more we keep it rotating, the more that balance starts to pick up, gets ready to fall. So here, number one. Slow right here. I'm starting to get the balance. I can't really resist anymore. Lift up and run through. Then other side, at speed. All right, thank you. Thank you. Now, next up, working that rotation, number one. Just pushing his arm around doesn't really get much done. Plus, he can be punching me in the face the whole time. So I want to be working to get that arm rotating. Get in, low, crank on it, right there. Attacking the arm from here, number two. So he takes my arm back, and notice my balance starts to go right in there. That's external rotation, same sort of thing. Thank you, Liza, come on in. Same sort of thing applies when you keep the rotation going. We'll do shihonage. So she blocks, takes me down, do it slowly. So here, she gets my arm rotating. Now at this point, you'll notice, the more she pulls, the more my body starts to move out of that range, and I'm gonna take the fall. And this time, full through. And upset. All right, thank you. All right, now one last thing before we go. The same sort of thing that we use to use the rotator cuff against them can be used in our favor. So here, Bill, number five. So if I'm trying to do an elbow lock against him, if my arm's real tight, arm stuck to my side, I'm trying to lift his elbow, I'm using that supraspinatus muscle, and it's weak. Feeling anything, Bill? The answer is no. So to move the arm effectively, I don't need that weak muscle, I need to use my deltoid. Instead of lifting his arm up, it's much better to just drop my center down and get into that elbow that way. Thank you. Number six. So here, not gonna work. Same resistance, I get low, different muscle group employed, works out. Thank you very much. So essentially, that's just a little short demo/lecture. Just wanted to give a little something new for you guys. Thank you all very much for coming, and stop on by anytime you like. Thank you.
Well, that was pretty cool.
Yeah.
So, you know, I've always thought of Dr. Ward as like a Jedi master. You know, he graces us with his presence on a daily basis. Makes me think I can master the Force.
Say no more, my young Padawan.
carried away.
Daniel!
I'm sorry. That was great, though. I feel amazing. Okay. Let's move on.
Yeah, let's go to the next performer after that. All right. Our next performer is Annie Rice.
Annie Rice grew up in central Wisconsin and graduated from Colby High School. Now, did you know Colby cheese is named after the town of Colby, Wisconsin?
Would you look at that?
Pretty amazing. And then the town is named after Jack Colby, the guy that brought the railroad through the town.
Wow.
I know. Try to contain yourself, everyone. Big information being dropped tonight.
So Annie will be playing an Evanescence medley on piano and singing. So let's welcome Annie to the stage.
These wounds won't seem to
I'm really awake now. I feel woken up inside.
Wow. That's great.
Yeah, thank you so much, Annie. That was amazing.
Yeah. So up next, we have another special dance performance for you guys.
Yes, yeah, so this Bollywood medley features dance from the Gujarat, Hyderabad, and Kerala regions of India.
This group of second-year students grew up learning these different styles of Indian dance and are excited to fuse them with modern music for a fun twist.
So everyone put your hands together for Gunja, Sharon, and Sanjana. Woo!
Oye, Ranta Yogi, 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 Ranta
Next, we have a very special performance for you all.
Okay, so Aaron, when I heard about this next performance, I had to see if I could do it. Are you ready?
Yeah, let's see it. What are you doing?
Thank you.
What was that?
Tube in throat singing.
No, Nathaniel, not tube in throat, tube in throat singing.
Oh, well, my mistake. Should have Googled that first.
Yeah, you should have read the script.
Sorry about that.
So let's welcome Sean Plyler to the stage, who discovered the mystic art of tube in throat singing when he was in college.
Well, apparently, Sean, this brother, he's no joke. He ran into a parked car with his bike head on, breaking off the hood ornament. He quickly learned how his pain and tears are what it takes to go head-to-head with a jaguar.
Wow. Sean also enjoys long walks on the beach, sipping pina coladas, virgin style. His other interests include flower gardening, car repair, and ice cream sampling. Let's welcome Sean! Woo!
The definition of follies is the state or quality of being foolish. Keep it the same tempo.
Well, that was something. Well, give it up for Sean one more time. Woo! All right. So now we really have a special treat for everyone. Get this. Everyone, look under your chairs. Look under your chairs. Look under them. One of you is the lucky winner of an all-expense-paid trip to the Greenbrier
for one week.
Okay, it's a lie. I'm sorry.
Oh,
I was trying to have an Oprah moment, all right? She's my spirit animal.
You had me shook.
Sorry.
Gosh. Okay, our next performers have been performing together for a very long time. A grand total of 3 weeks.
Count them, three.
Yes. Maria Sena will be singing, accompanied by Eric Nikolai. They have truly enjoyed putting off studying to prepare for today's performance. Please give it up for Eric and Maria. Woo!
Yeah. some cover, share some skin. Clouds are shrouding us in moments unforgettable. Your twist to fit the mold that I am in. Oh, but things just get so crazy living. Life gets hard to do. And I would gladly hit the road, get up and go if I knew that someday it would lead me back to you. Oh, that someday it would lead me back to you. That may be all I need. In darkness, she is all I see. Come and rest your bones with me. Driving slow on Sunday morning, and I never want to leave.
Tornado flew around my room before you came. Excuse the mess we made, it usually doesn't rain. Southern California, much like Arizona. My eyes don't shed tears before they fall. When I'm thinking about you, you know, no, no. I've been thinking about you, you know, no, no. I've been thinking about you. Do you think about still? Do you, do you?
Do you not think so far?
Nathaniel, we've been watching people perform all night. They've been doing such cool things like singing and dancing and martial schnarch.
Yeah.
I mean, martial arts. That one was on purpose.
And now it's our turn to do something crazy.
Yes, it is. Do
you
want us
to
do
see
something?
Us perform?
We're going
to
do it anyway, even if
we
don't want to.
Of?
All right, let's get Stephanie, our SGA vice president, out here and make something happen.
Okay, places, everybody.
She packed my bags last night, pre-flight. 0 hour, 9 a.m. And I'm gonna be high as a kite by then. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time till touchdown brings me round again to find I'm not the man they think I am at home. Oh no, 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 I'm a rocket man, rocket man.
One opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted in one moment. Did you capture it? Just let it slip. Yo.
You better lose yourself in the music the moment you own it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot. Do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better lose yourself in the music the moment you own it.
Fun.
Yeah.
Thanks for indulging us, guys.
It was.
Okay, so we have one more act for you tonight, and Aaron, what an awful noise you're making.
hold on, one more. I don't think it's working. All right, you know, I'm just trying to fit in with our next act here. Yeah, you go for it. See how hard it is. Okay, that's worse, Nathaniel. That's worse than me.
I tried.
I give you that for trying.
Okay, so it's really hard to play these instruments.
So we're not going to do it anymore.
Yeah, so I'm just going to introduce the next people, okay? Triple F Brass is a group of faculty, friends, and family members who love playing music. They're playing a diverse range of music from pop, jazz, to classical, patriotic, and even holiday music.
Wow. I heard that they even play at the local nursing home. How sweet is that?
Wow.
And also, together they can play over 30 instruments.
That is very impressive.
Wow.
So let's give it up for Triple F Brass.
Woo!
One, two, ready. special guests who are going to come play with us for our last one.
Again.
Yeah.
Woo! All right, everyone. So it seems we have to bring the night to a close, unfortunately. So yeah. The 2020 SAAO Follies is done.
Very sad.
Oh.
We had some truly amazing performances tonight, did we not? Let's give it up.
Give it up for the performers one more time. All right, so... it has been a pleasure for me and Nathaniel here to be your MCs for the night. I hope you enjoyed our cheesy jokes and props and everything we did. We had a ton of fun. All right, so we're going to turn things back over to Matt and Sim from the SAAO. Here we are. Give them
Woo!
A clap.
Come on. All righty, everyone. So was that a pretty good resurrection? All right. What a dang show.
Wow, I am mind blown with the amazing talents we have on this campus. From lip syncing to stand-up comedy to dancing, and of course, the Tuvian throat singing. I mean, guys, how amazing was that?
All right, so at this point in time, I just want to have all of the performers come up onto the stage to take their bow. But as that's going on...
and while we're getting everyone up here, we would like to thank a few people.
So I want to first start off by saying thank you to the students, because without their bravery and honestly an excuse to stop studying for a night, we would not have been able to make this possible. I also really want to thank Mark and Belinda because they took our ideas and allowed us to really run with them and make this a reality, which is pretty crazy. And absolutely the media services, without them, the lights wouldn't have come on, the music wouldn't have worked, and nobody would have been able to do anything. So we really thank you guys, and we really appreciate you for that. So Kyle, can you come out as well and take a bow? Because Kyle, get out here. Let's go. All right. And the stagehands, you guys are out there too, perfect. Man, because we are sweaty, I was back there. Whoo, it is hot.
Furthermore, we would like to thank Chef Adam and the catering staff for the amazing food.
Yeah. The meatballs are always a hit.
And SAO Ebor, Marissa, Brittany, Brady, and Aubrey. The Blue Crew, they set up all the tables. They're amazing, and we don't deserve them. And last but not least, our lovely host of the night, Nathaniel Jordan and Aaron Big Skinny.
So, without further ado, we would like to conclude the 2020 SAAO Follies with a lovely bow from all of our performers. You guys did an amazing job, and thank you so, so much.
All right, now for the greatest walkout music of all time. I want to thank everyone for coming out here tonight. It's been an amazing show. Take it away, Triple F.